Delivering fantastic customer experience. How to turn customer satisfaction into customer relationships. By Daniel Lafrenière. Read by Christopher Ragland. Preface. The world is reveling in mediocrity, and I've had enough. I'm tired of not knowing what is going on when my flight is delayed or canceled, and am left in a lurch. I'm tired of giving the impression of being incompetent when it comes to choosing a computer or a cell phone plan. I'm tired of not understanding anything when I fill out an insurance or government claim form. I'm tired of contracts impossible to decipher without a law degree. I'm tired of hidden charges, price increases, or unexpected changes in billing. I'm tired of wasting my time repeating my issue to many people when I need help. I'm tired of having new customers get a better price or privilege compared to me who has been loyal for years. I'm tired of being served by unprofessional, unskilled people who give me the impression I'm disturbing them. I'm tired of being treated like a number, a file, or a case without any consideration or empathy. I'm tired of being literally punished when I make an inadvertent mistake. I'm tired of being a prisoner of a provider or a product. I'm tired of navigating the mazes of telephone systems just to reach a dead end, dealing with robots, not humans, not finding what I was looking for, getting hung up on, or waiting for what seems like hours before being answered. I'm tired of having to create a profile with a password worthy of the NSA, add 8 characters with at least 1 capital letter, 1 number, and 1 special character that I'll certainly forget, only to buy a movie ticket or be notified by SMS of the receipt of a parcel. I'm tired of not knowing exactly when a delivery person or an installer will come by. I'm sick of having to wait hours on end for a company to show up. I'm tired of having to call back several times to make sure that an error made by a provider has indeed been corrected. I'm tired of people not respecting their commitments. I'm tired of not being told thank you when I buy a product or a service. I have the right, as a client, citizen, patient, to simplicity, being heard, expert advice, respect, and empathy. I'm fed up especially because human and technological solutions exist for a good customer experience and can be set up easily, quickly, and oftentimes affordably. In a nutshell, I am tired of complicated procedures, and I am tired of wasting my time. Add up all the minutes, all the hours wasted because of complexity, inefficiency, incompetence, a lack of commitment, or just plain carelessness. Those minutes and hours are stacking up to quite a lot in a lifetime. This must end. Now. Introduction. Why a book on customer experience? Sometimes one bad experience can break a long-standing relationship with a customer, and an unsatisfied customer is likely to spread the bad news to many people, especially at a time when social media can bring down a company's reputation in no time flat. Studies have shown that 60% of customers would happily switch companies to have a better shopping experience. At this point, I am not even talking about the tons of other studies, reports, and editorials that show that customers are tired of not being appreciated and respected for their true value. Except for some extraordinary brands, most companies unfortunately offer a customer experience that is ho-hum at best, and often mediocre. It seems that we have forgotten the fine art of good business. Why this book? As I browsed through bookstores and looked at all the research and information available, I came to the conclusion that there was not a simple, practical, no-nonsense book on how businesses of any sizes, B2C or B2B, can improve their customer experience without a master's degree, an army of experts, or breaking the bank. Most of the books are for CXO, Chief Experience Officers, or Customer Experience Designers. None are for managers and employees. So, I decided to write one. Who is this book for? This book is for anyone who works in a company at the service of consumers, B2C, or other businesses, B2B. Executives, advisors, salespeople, marketing, website or accounting managers, customer service agents, delivery people, installers, etc., all have an important role to play in creating a company's customer experience. If you are a human and interact with other humans, physically or digitally, this book is for you. What will you get out of this book? In less than 90 minutes, the time it takes to listen to this book, you will learn what customer experience truly is, how emotions can increase customer loyalty or make customers ditch a brand, which behaviors and attitudes lose customers, 10 easy and proven ways to improve customer experience realistically, sustainably, and affordably right now with practical tips and real-life stories, what renowned companies do to offer the best customer experience. Based on research, more than 100 references, and years of practice in the field, the content of this book can be applied to a variety of domains: retail, government, banking, financial and insurance, health, manufacturing, etc. You could use it to improve customer experience in stores, call centers, websites, or any other channel that you use to interact with your customers. Warning. To support my examples and recommendations, I selected a limited number of companies. They've been chosen because the quality of their customer experience is renowned and can be a source of inspiration for any business, no matter the size. Of course, they are not the only ones to offer a quality customer experience. Finally, it is also important to note that I am not a spokesperson for the companies mentioned in this book. Chapter 1. What is customer experience? Before even thinking of improving your customer experience, we have to agree on a definition. Customer experience is the emotion felt by customers when they come into any contact with a company, no matter how or by what means. It is what customers remember from their interaction with a business. Whenever customers hear about a business on TV or social media, call or visit a point of sales/service, visit a website, or use a mobile app, they come into contact with this company and its brand. Customers forge opinions based on the emotions felt during this contact. This experience is what could possibly trigger a conversation, relationship, loyalty, or evangelization with other customers. This experience could also lead to frustration, customer churn or aversion, and even revenge on social media. In fact, providing a good customer experience is relatively simple. It suffices that the client, patient, or user feels welcomed, helped, appreciated, understood, heard, happy, important, cared for, reassured, acknowledged, respected, and pleasantly surprised. At all costs, businesses do not want customers to feel depressed, abandoned, confused, disappointed, exploited, frustrated, humiliated, ignored, incompetent, misunderstood, irritated, taken for granted, ridiculed, unjustly treated, treated like a number, or unpleasantly surprised. Remember that time when your car broke down on the highway with the kids, when you were hospitalized, when a sales associate did not really want to help you, but rather simply sell you a product as quickly as possible. Your credit card was cloned while you were out of the country, when your smartphone stopped working, etc. It is at these critical moments, called moments of truth, that customers judge a company based on the emotions they feel and decide to either pursue the business relationship or swiftly put an end to it at the first opportunity. Positive emotions build customer loyalty. Negative emotions make customers run away. It's as simple as that. The human experience. Social skills, attitude, and know-how, competence, have a direct impact on customer experience. A smiling, polite employee who knows how to interpret the customer's moods and expectations and is familiar with their products or services certainly evokes positive emotions. On the flip side, a jaded employee who looks like they don't want to be working, acts emotionless and knows little about the products or services of the company, and who does not seem to care, causes negative emotional reactions. The physical experience. The premises, the layout, the ease of movement, the lighting, the decor, the displays, the furniture, the smells, the music, the parking space, the interior and exterior signage all play an important role. The digital experience. Ease of use, navigation, and search are essential in providing a good digital customer experience, whether on the web or on a mobile app. The aesthetics, the vocabulary used, and the communication of the company's brand are also important. More on this in Chapter 7. Chapter 2. Why is customer experience so important? A survey conducted in 2018 showed that the five elements that provide great customer experiences are 1. Quality of the service, 49%. 2. Courtesy of the staff, 44%. 3. Personalization of the offer, 39%. 4. Quality of the greeting, 27%. And 5. Competence of the staff, 24%. Unsurprisingly, 86% of the people who have had an exceptional customer experience definitely consider doing business again with the same company, a proportion that goes up to 92% when you're already a customer. Conversely, only 9% of repeat customers said with certainty that they would do business with a company again after having a very bad customer experience. Among the new customers, none had a firm intention to come back. There are consequences to offering a bad customer experience. Here are other eloquent numbers. In 2017, 50% of customers switched providers because they did not feel valued, had interacted with rude employees, or did not get help from employees. More than 80% of customers would be willing to pay more for a better customer experience. And the acquisition cost of a new customer is 5 to 25 times higher or even more than the cost of retaining an existing customer. A question of value for the customer. In 2016, Eric Almquist and his colleagues published a seminal paper presenting 30 elements of value for clients, grouped in a pyramid.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.